Do you want to learn how to paint like Alexei von Jawlensky landscapes, and also about the Blauwe Reiter group or the Blue Rider art movement? Just after this. Hey, Albert here at Imperfect Paintings, where it's all about improving your painting skills by looking at art yourself and the world around you. In case you're new to this channel, why not subscribe and click on the bell so you'll be notified of the next video. Alexei von Jawlensky was one of the artists that formed the group or art movement Der Blaue Reiter or the Blue Rider. The group was formed in Europe by a number of Russian immigrants, including Vasily Kandinsky. Alexei von Jawlensky, Marianne von Werfkin, and native German artists such as Franz Marc, August Macke, and Gabriele Münter. The Blaue Reiter group lasted from 1911 to 1914, and the artists produced expressive, brightly colored paintings, which were the prompt to development of Expressionism in Germany. When I look at the landscape paintings by Alexei von Jawlensky, I don't see perfect paintings. Instead, I see a kind of happy experimenting with colors and playing with the idea how to paint a landscape. It looks like you can do whatever you want, as long as it looks expressive. Let's take this one and look a bit longer. I see mountains in different colors. The colors don't have to be realistic. The colors are in a number of shades painted. The painting is painted in a messy, childlike or playful manner. And Jawlensky sometimes uses a contour line. The way the forms are painted is like they are jumping around instead of standing still as mountains usually do. It makes me smile. To make it more easy for myself, I use a photograph as a starting point to create my own version in the way of Alexei von Jawlensky artwork. I start with the sky. I put too much paint on the paper and take some away with a tissue. Magenta for the mountains. This is so much fun. I'm able to take any color and it just feels right. You should try this for yourself too. Because I work with transparent colors, I have to apply an extra layer of paint to create a darker color for the mountains. The picture is complete for the first layer of paint. Red for a lower mountain, green for the vegetation down to the water, and yellow for the bottom part of the painting. Now I apply a second layer of paint in different tones to create more diversity and also attempt to integrate the way Alexei von Jawlensky makes his paintings. Perhaps you already noticed that I'm not a very precise and neat painter. I work more roughly around to get the painting done. It's a matter of personal preference if you like the result or not. What will happen by this way of painting, and also because of the transparency of the colors, is that every color plane gets a more active feel to it. When I would paint it very precise, it would more look like a jigsaw puzzle, where you would see the exact line between every part in a certain color. It could become more static. In my opinion, my way of painting looks more lively and interesting. This way of painting is also a very easy way for the participants of my painting course. Just paint and get going and keep on going. Try as long as you can not to judge what you make. And when you have tasted the fun of painting, it can become a hobby for a lifetime. The changes are getting smaller and smaller as usual in my paintings. I look at my painting where I like it and where it looks less interesting. By changing the less interesting or boring parts, you can work your way around in your painting and get it to a higher level. What I notice while making this painting is that the expressionism of Der Blaue Reiter group and the use of bright colors has a poetic side to it. The artist worked instinctively, generally using bright colors, and were fascinated by nature and animals. By using different colors, the painting gets a strange, unworldly, fairy tale-like feel, what amuses me. The painting reminds me of the photograph I started from, but appears to be from a different universe. It's a great exercise to enhance your painting skills. Here are the results of the participants of my painting course. Enjoy! Did you like this video? Give it a thumbs up and share it with a friend. Subscribe and click on the bell so you'll be notified of the next video. Click or tap on the screen to see another one. And until next time, keep painting!